Christ.
Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, whose blessed Son was led by the Spirit to be tempted by Satan, come quickly to help us who are assaulted by many temptations. And as you know the weaknesses of each of us, let each one find you mighty to save. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Not obey when God waited patiently in the day.
days of Noah, during the building of the ark, which a few, that is, 8 persons, were saved through water. The baptism, which this prefigured, now saves you, not as a removal of dirt from the body, but as an appeal to God for a good conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of the God with angels, authorities, and powers made subject to him. The word of the Lord.
This is really happening. I never would have dreamed that of a time when I'd be woken up in the wee hours of Saturday morning to be told at my front door that St. Luke's is on fire and it is a total loss. And then going over to the campus and actually seeing the building on fire, it was surreal. I still can hardly believe it. You know, we oftentimes will say that the church is not the building. The church is the people. The church is not a building. The church is the people. That's true. That's very true. The church is the people of God. Even here in a middle school gymnasium on a basketball court, we are still the body of Christ, gathered for worship and for praise. But there is another truth that we need to face, and that is that this is a grievous loss. It is devastating. This is like experiencing a death. It is true that the church is a building, but the church is also more than just a building. It's sacred space. It's space that has been consecrated, set apart as holy for the holy life-transforming work of God. And just think about how many thousands of people over the years have knelt at that altar. Think of all the baptisms, the confirmations, the weddings, and the funerals that have taken place in that space. The way in which that space has helped people mark the most important times of joy and sorrow in their lives, and doing so with the love and the grace of God. Think of all the countless school chapel services that have connected our teachers and staff and students and families, not just to the Episcopal tradition, but to the living Lord that we honor and that we worship. Think about your memories, your precious memories of being in that space with family, with friends, with all who gather. The stained glass windows, that imposing Christus Rex cross towering over the congregation, that imposing altar, the impressive pipe organ, shake the rafters, the beautiful contemplative chapel, the kneelers, the preludes, all of it gone. Our hearts are broken. But you know, even in the midst of loss and grief, there are so many reasons why even today we can have gratitude and give thanks to God and have hope. For starters, we can give thanks for whoever it was from our neighbors at the Baton Rouge Police Department that saw there was a fire and called it in. If that hadn't happened, this could have been a lot worse. And then, of course, the fire department. Wow. Those guys are unbelievable. They're not only professional, but just they understood that they were dealing with sacred space. And they were just so wonderful to work with, and they're heroes. Some of y'all have heard that, you know, they went into the building when it was on fire, and the roof collapsed on three of the firefighters, one of whom was trapped for a bit. Fortunately, they got out. No one was injured, or worse. Thanks be to God. And then the steady stream of people coming and going all throughout the day, starting in the wee hours of the morning into the evening, bearing witness to the love that we have for St. Luke's and for one another. A lot of non-St. Luke's folks showed up as well. People who don't even go to our church because they care. They wanted to let us know that they're praying for us. It's a powerful witness that we are strong and resilient. A community of love that has blessed more people than we could possibly imagine. I'm very thankful for Bishop Shannon and her husband Jimmy, who came in the early hours yesterday morning to be with us, and Father Tommy Dillon, a son of St. Luke's was with us as well. He's here today also. Churches all around the diocese have reached out. In fact, the vestments I'm wearing, Father Ralph Howe is there. I look good in these, don't I? Pretty good. They fit pretty good, Ralph. I'm grateful to him because we can have this, but also vestments from St. Margaret, St. James. The fact that we can have a Eucharist today is because of the generosity of our sister churches. Episcopalians from all over the country and Anglicans around the world, they're praying for us today in their services, and they will be in the weeks and days to come. Pastors from Methodist, Lutheran, Baptist, Catholic, and Unitarian churches have reached out to us, saying that we can have their space if we need it. It's a wonderful reminder that shared faith in Jesus Christ, it trumps so many of the things that divide us. Those differences just melt away in the aftermath of a fire. And thanks to Broadmoor Baptist for providing their shuttle to get folks back and forth from parking at the police department next door. Friends, we are not alone. We are remembered. We are loved. And we're going to get through this. Jesus made it through his time of trial in the wilderness as angels ministered to him. And we will be angels who minister to each other as together we walk through this wilderness to reach the other side. You know, I think it's fair to say that Good Friday has come early this Lent. I mean, giving something up for Lent is ridiculous. So I think our Lenten disciplines have backed up a little bit, don't you think? Good Friday's come a little early. But even in the midst of crucifixion, joy and hope of Easter still shines. You see this processional cross? Some of you may recognize this is one of the crosses that we use quite a bit in our worship services. It looks a little different, doesn't it? The heat was so intense that it warped and it bent this cross, but it did not destroy it. Like this cross, we've also been burned. Our church is literally burned, our hearts and our souls have been burned. We've been warped, we've been bent out of shape by unforeseen and unimaginable loss. But we've also not been broken, just as this cross still stands and bears witness to a living war. So friends, Easter is coming. Jesus will rise from the grave, and we will rise again with him to do the work that he has given us to do. So don't lose hope. Look at all the people who are here today. There are many, many others I'm aware of who couldn't be here today. It's a lot of folks. And together, we are going to walk in this wilderness to a new day for St. Luke's, with a new building and a renewed commitment to our mission and to our ministries. Thank you all for being a part of that sacred journey. Amen.
We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, of God, that it may be filled with truth and love and be found without fault at the day of your coming. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Bishop Duckworth, Father Brian, Mother Trish, for all bishops and other ministers, and for all the holy people of God, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our divisions may cease, and that all may be one as you and the Father are one, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among nations and peoples, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in positions of public trust, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this congregation, for those who are present and for those who are absent, that we may be delivered from hardness of heart and show forth your glory in all that we do, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the strength to persevere in the wake of the fire, that with God's help we may rebuild and re-engage our mission and ministry stronger than ever, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have commended themselves to our prayers, for our families, friends, and neighbors, that being freed from anxiety, they may live in joy, peace, and health, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in need of healing, including Dan, Bob, and Ann, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who await the birth of a baby, including Austin and Anna Catherine Jackson, son and daughter-in-law of Steve and Chris Jackson, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died in the communion of your church, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints, they may rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our neighbors at the Baton Rouge Police Department, and especially the Baton Rouge Fire Department, for all law enforcement officers, firefighters, emergency responders, and medical workers who serve our community, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the teachers, staff, students, and families of St. Luke's Episcopal School, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Rejoicing in the fellowship of the ever-blessed Virgin Mary, Luke the Evangelist, and all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God.
O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, a lover of souls. And to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. And
Lord be always with you. Please be seated. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to St. Luke's. Seriously, thank you all. I mean, it's wonderful to see such a strong show of love and support. It really means the world. It really does. So thank you for being here today. I note that our hospitality crew has some food available. They've even got some coffee going, I think. So afterwards, please feel free to linger as we have fellowship and just love one another and support each other during this difficult time. And many thanks to everyone who helped out in so many ways yesterday, as well as this morning. It's really a powerful testimony to what it means to be the body of Christ. So thank you for that. Looking ahead, I gather that the ECW garage sale, we're still going to try to do that next Saturday, and then we're going to clear that space out, and we're going to start using Witter Hall for our worship space on Sundays. So we'll remind folks of that in our communications, but just so you're aware, the times to be determined. It's like so many other things, our formation, other activities, a lot of stuff is just up in the air right now. We really don't know what is going to happen when, and it's really kind of crazy. More information on all of that will be coming, but I know, for example, the grief group was going to meet tomorrow. That's been canceled, postponed to another time. So we'll share more information as we know more, because right now, I think we're still all just kind of reeling from the initial shock of what has happened. And as we get our bearings, we'll have a better feel for what's coming next. One issue that's come up a lot, and for really good reason, is concern about the column barrier. A lot of folks have called, have come onto the campus, and tried to go into the church, actually, which please do not do that. It's still a very dangerous site. We're going to block it off so you can't get in. But please do not go into that space. It's still very dangerous. But I want to reassure you that that resting place for the remains of our loved ones is intact. It's still standing. It is fire and waterproof. I think it could withstand a lot more than happened. It's still there. So please know that is safe, and before we're able to do much with where we try to relocate things, we have to contact the cemetery board. There's a whole process that we go through. But I just want you to know that's a top priority that we're going to be working on this week as we figure out how we're going to handle where that is going to be stored during the interim period. Also, for communion, we're going to have three stations, one in the middle, one here to my left, and one here over to the right of me. Each station will have one paten with bread and two chalices of wine. So if you come and get bread and one chalice, somebody's there, please go to the other chalice that's open. That'll help facilitate things, keep things going smoothly. But just so you're aware, that's how we're going to handle communion today. And at this time, I'd like to call on Bishop Shannon to share a few thoughts with you.
So I don't know if many of you know this, but Brian and I have been doing ministry together the entire time we've been doing ministry, starting in Mississippi and of course now in the Diocese of Louisiana. And getting up and preaching in a moment like this is hard work. And that was an absolutely beautiful sermon. It spoke.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ, our Lord, who was tempted in every way as we are, yet did not sin. By his grace, we are able to triumph over every evil and to live no longer for ourselves alone, but for him who died for us and rose again. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us eat and drink.
mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. These are the gifts of God and the people of God.
She doesn't take them in first.
Thank you. know. Y'all can go next. Middle.
Thank you.
Go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor all persons. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Amen.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.